But Lydia is very, very different to that of the characters that I've played before, particularly Arya Stark. She invests a lot of emotional energy into other people. She feels very secure with her best friend, Abigail, and really kind of struggles to make new friends and struggles to kind of break out of this really tight bond that the two of them have. And when Abigail kind of shows signs of growing up and having sex and meeting boys and speaking to different girls, and it really kind of shakes Lydia's world. And it just kind of explores the emotions and the feelings and thoughts that you have as a teenager growing up. And when your hormones are all over the place, I think it kind of just did that really, really honestly. And then when tragedy strikes amongst the school and there's a mass fainting epidemic, Lydia takes it upon herself to figure out what's going on, and she truly believes there's something in the school, the teachers have done something, there's something wrong, something seriously wrong, and you really get that feeling in the movie. Along the way, you discover some really deep secrets about certain characters. I think I like to pretend that I'm very similar to Arya. I like to pretend that I could like pull out a sword and like kill anyone that hurt me. But I think Lydia's got something that we all see in ourselves, and it's that kind of comfort when you have your strong base of friends or your family around you, and how that really kind of, how that makes you feel so stable. And then when that's kind of shaken up, you feel a bit lost, I guess. No, I'm really, really excited to be here, and I'm so, so thrilled that the film's been received so well. And when you put it like that, that does sound very...
Didn't mean to scare you.
No, not at all, but like that's really, really exciting. Thank you.
So my first question is Carol. Yes. What were your inspirations for writing the screenplay for this
film? I think I made a short film about mass hysteria, mass psychogenic illness, and I think I became very, very intrigued about what lies behind an outbreak of mass hysteria when everyone starts to become ill and faint and stuff like that. So I really wanted to explore it further, and it often happens amongst young women. So I thought it'd be a great opportunity to look at sort of female adolescence and really explore what it's like to be a young girl in a more dynamic way than has maybe been done before.
I noticed shades of like gothic literature, like the Yellow Wallpaper by Charlotte Perkins. Yeah. Were you inspired by anything like that?
I think you just, I think it's really that you take on board so much experience through your life, and you want to express it. And in fact, I think I would be quite ill if I didn't get these things out of my head.
Yeah.
So I think I have had so many influences. I'm liking that people are connecting it to Picnic at Hanging Rock, because it's a film I really, really, really love, the Peter Weir film, so I love that. But the influences are so many. And of course, so what attracted me to it was really looking at really filmically exploring young women in a dynamic way, and maybe a way that's not been done for a long time.
And Florence, what's it like to be part of that?
I think to be part of all of this is mainly down to all the women that I've been working with. I was given a great opportunity to work alongside four of the greats, Maisie, Greta, Monica, and Maxine Peake. And of course, I couldn't have asked for a better setup than my first gig, really. Learned everything new, every single day. And, you should see what it looks like in a bit.
I've already seen it. Yeah.
You've seen it?
I'm a big fan of it.
Yeah?
Yes, we've got a fan! One fan, all it takes.
I'm sure down the line you'll get many more.
Yeah, okay.
But, so what is it like, just as your first gig, what is it like?
You know what, it's still much of a shock now. I this is all really new to me. This is new to me. I got it exactly a year ago, and so I'm still learning now what it was like. It was a dream, really. I mean, I had the best director to welcome me to this lifestyle, this career, and one big amazing lesson that I couldn't have dream for, which is
basically I really wish Florence a lot of luck in her future career, but I don't want her to work with anyone else, so I'm feeling quite possessive.
But you could have got that in a contract.
I did.
She's already mentioned.
Yeah, I have. Hi. The film is set in 1969 in a girls' school in a rural part of England, and there is a mysterious outbreak of mass hysteria. Florence here is a key girl. She's kind of the girl that's really admired at school. She plays Abby. And as the film goes on, we begin to look at what lies behind this mysterious case of fainting that goes on in the school.
So first of all, how was this film today?
Amazing, as I just said. It was it was, I had Maisie to teach me all the way through. I had Carol to lead me alongside. And I think really what everyone's got to keep in mind is that this is just a story, much like most girls nowadays, except it's set in 1969. And I think that's something that you should really focus on, really. Yeah. The fact that, you know, you look at girls nowadays, they wouldn't be really doing much different.
Yeah, it's just now, and now you have more technology, yeah, but exactly. Actually the emotions and the feelings exactly are very the same, similar.
Which is why when you watch it, I think most women will feel a great connection towards it.
First of all, how did you discover Florence here?
Well, I when you write a script, you have a particular person in mind, and it's very, very important to cast it right. So we spent a lot of time looking for Florence Pugh's character, Abby, and we, in fact, leafleted. We, in the end, knew we were going to film in the Oxford area, and we leafleted the Oxford area for young women of a certain age to come forward. And we got thousands of people sending in one-minute tapes with the casting agent, Shaheen Baig, and we came across Florence's tape and called her in. And in fact, I saw her outside and I said, could you take all your makeup off, please? And I made her go to the toilet and wipe all her makeup off. She'd come really beautifully, you know, conferred, or whatever the word is. But yeah, so she was discovered from thousands. And I really feel that you will, you just have an amazing instinct. She's a real natural. She was brilliant in front of the camera at the audition. And as soon as she walked in the door without the makeup on, I thought, that's her. That's Abby.
Thanks.
This is a very different film compared to Dreams of Life. What made you want to pick up this film and start writing it?
You see, I actually think it's not that. It is different in some ways, but in many ways it's the same thematics. You know, it's looking at kind of female experience, it's looking at female subjectivity, it's looking at how we present ourselves to the world and our identities, teenage identities. Incredibly fascinating. So I think in many ways, Dreams of a Life was about the search for identity, and I think in this film is too.
And what was it like being a newcomer to work alongside such an amazing cast and crew?
Well, as I said earlier, this is all very new to me. I mean, I've only got the film about a year ago, so everything is still new. I still don't know what's going on. I'm still being led along by Carol, Maisie. And my experience was amazing. It was a dream, basically. I got given the best cast to work with.
Well, also, I think what was
the best director.
No, I think what's good as well is that you were with Maisie, who had quite a lot of experience, because then it's sort of your peer group helping you and giving you insight into a way that I couldn't, you know. So I think that you
I was
very
much led by the hand through the whole thing.
No, I know. No. She's innately got it.